A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 26 June, on the front page you have this coverage on state of health. It says, among bigger states, Kerala scored the highest in 2017-18 composite health index prepared by Niti Aayog. So this Niti Aayog index incorporates 23 indicators, and the graph shows the scores for 2015-16-17 and 2017-18 as well as the change. So you can see 15-16 is shown in yellowish orange dot, and blue dot shows 2017-18. So the change in the score is shown for the states, you can see. And it is said UP scored the lowest and remained at the least ranked state. Then here you have help fulfill the dream of a safe, modern, inclusive nation. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has made an appeal on this. And this is Antigua not providing Mehul safe haven, says its PM. So Antigua is the place where Mehul Choksi, who is wanted in the PNB scam case along with Nirav Modi, Antigua is where he is located. But then Antigua PM says that he has not been provided a safe haven there, and the citizenship which is there on him, it will be revoked. He will be extradited once he exhausts his legal options. Then on page 5 you have Haryana tightens provisions of act to curb cow slaughter. So the Haryana cabinet has amended the Haryana Gauvansh Sanrakshan and Gau Samvardhan Act of 2015. It says a technical mistake was there in the act which has been corrected. The word beef has been included in it. Then on page 8 you have give 9.19 TMC feet Kaveri water to Tamil Nadu. So this is Kaveri Water Management Authority, which has told Karnataka government to release 9.19 TMC feet, that is 1000 million cubic feet of water, for the month of June from its Biligundlu point on the interstate border to the Metro dam in Tamil Nadu. So Kaveri water dispute had been a protracted issue. Eventually the Kaveri Water Management Authority has been established by the government to look into the river water sharing. Then this is Andhra Pradesh will withdraw bauxite mining go, says Jagan. So TDP government here didn't allow, TDP government actually didn't allow mining, but it failed to scrap the order too. So now Andhra Pradesh will withdraw the bauxite mining go, the order as such too. So there were these go and no go zones which were, you know, initiated by the former environment minister Jairam Ramesh. So this is in that context. And here you have joint effort to conserve wildlife at Bandipur. So an interstate meet took place which discussed ways to mitigate man-animal conflict in the region. So it is senior forest personnel from Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Kerala which met at Bandipur in Karnataka. So to decide on conservation efforts, so joint efforts are being undertaken. Then on page 9 you have 31.4% of Indian children will be stunted by 2022. So means almost one third of Indian children under 5 years will still be stunted by 2022, going by the current trends, according to an analysis of country's food and nutrition security. It says country needs to double its efforts to control malnutrition. And below you have impressive tortoise discovered in Arunachal. So a tortoise considered beautiful enough to be named impressed has been discovered in Arunachal Pradesh. Then on the editorial page you have the first editorial, lynching redux. So this is regarding yesterday's front page news in Jharkhand. A youth was lynched by the mob. So it says this is another instance of mob mentality combining with communal motive. And this is a city gone dry. So this is regarding the water crisis in Chennai, how even Kerala had also offered to provide water, drinking water to Chennai. So it says the water crisis in Chennai needs holistic and widely resonant solutions. So this is a very important issue. The lead article, the future of parliamentary democracy. So this talks of how an individual eclipses his party in the parliamentary election. It is an uncharted terrain for the system. So, so in parliamentary democracy, how an individual is also important. So it says after the nation gave a decisive mandate, political analysts have yet to come up with a plausible reason for what happened. No one had forecast this kind of majority, though there are many who now claim they saw it coming. So, so this is an individual, the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who eclipsed his party in the parliamentary elections. So this article talks of future of parliamentary democracy in this context. Like, it is a presidential style voting which took place actually. And this is the state of Indian prisons. So it talks of the National Crime Records Bureau, how it must be more prompt and open in releasing data. So there are no demographic details. The data on prisoner release is required. Mental health concerns are also raised with respect to prisoners. Then on the op-ed page, you have an indecent settlement. So this is regarding Johnson & Johnson's Paltrow settlement for its faulty hip transplants. And this is called problematic in this article. On page 13, you have trade missile on agenda during Pompeo visit. So this is regarding US Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, who will be on a visit to India, who is on a visit to India. He'll hold talks with S. Jai Shankar, the External Affairs Minister, and Ajit Doval. So he'll also meet Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So this is also regarding the trade between the two nations, how India's exports to USA have reduced, and India's imports from USA are also shown in blue here. So what USA wants is the trade deficit has to be narrowed. So India has a trade surplus with USA. On international page, you have India-Pakistan clash over Nizam of Hyderabad's funds in UK. So this is decades old legal dispute between India and Pakistan over £35 million belonging to Nizam of Hyderabad. So at the time of partition, he deposited it in the London bank account, and now it is in the courts of UK. The case is in courts of UK regarding who would possess it, India or Pakistan. Then on business page, you have this is cash in circulation fell post note ban. So finance minister says demonetization exercise of 2016 succeeded in reducing notes in circulation by 3.4 lakh crores. And then you have foreign e-commerce firms warned against steep online discounts. So government is committed to protecting small retailers, and a warning has been given to e-commerce firms. And you have below, Sinha-led panel proposes 5,000 crore stressed asset fund for micro, small and medium enterprises. So this fund, which is proposed, as such, will assist units becoming sick due to changes in external factors. Then there's no news on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.